I will be talking essentially, it's not the new science, but the science and the progress. Therefore, probably I would try to just restrict to say that actually what's that we have been doing in the last 2 years. It's about trying to understand the ice dynamics and past climate of the Trondheim Nordland region using through the project called MADRIS. It's of course I need to say that actually it's a collaborative project with the Norwegian Polar Institute and National Center for Antarctic and Ocean Research, and I thank my co-PI Kenny Matsuoka at the Norwegian Polar Institute. It's been quite great working together. Just starting with the slide, I will not go detail here. I just want to say that of course many of us do understand Antarctica is warming. So what are the consequences? The consequences are many folds, including the surface melt of many of the ice sheets, loss of many ice sheets. You must have heard, of late, loss of icebergs and, this is some of the stories we often quite hear in the newspapers. What you should also understand, this is not something new, it's been happening, but the magnitude as well as the frequency is increasing year after year, because the ability of the ice shells to withstand by themselves is decreasing. So if you look at Larsen C ice shells itself, you know, of course, we lost ice Larsen A, Larsen B, and Larsen C, part of it now. So the essential component which I want to say that what is basically stopping some of the ice shelves are some of this what we call ice rises. And the ice rises do have a very significant role in on the stability of this ice shelf. And this is something like look like in the field an ice rise, just a small hill, but this is the ice shelf. And what I wanted to say here, actually, they could be acting, in fact, that's the basic hypothesis we started this study together. The ice races could be acting like a cork of a bottle. As we are not interested in a cork, we are always interested in the wine or what is there inside the bottle. But if cork is not there, essentially there's nothing remains inside, you know, everything comes up. That's what I just wanted to convey here. And if you look at the Trondheim Nordland region, which is part of the East Antarctica, where the Norway as well as India has been working. In fact, we are the closest neighbors, in fact, with the Norway as well as India in Trondheim Nordland, just separated by about 300 kilometers. And we realized there is an opportunity to study the fast flowing some of these ice shelves and the glaciers which is feeding them. If you look at the entire Trondheim Nordland, there are many of them very fast, you know, this is the speed, the flow speed. Some of them are, running to 300 meter per year, and including the Nibelsen ice shelf, which is close to my area, running about 60 meter per year. So that's that's what's happening. So, but therefore, we want to know how stable are they? What was its past history? How could be the responding in future? That's the genesis of this particular project. If you look at the Norway and India collaborated basically with that essential understanding. What, how, and when it's going to change. And the main objectives of this project was to understand the current status and dynamics of these ice shelves in the Trondheim Nordland, to basically decipher the sensitivities to the future climate change. To also to study the long-term evolution of the ice rises, how did they acted in the past, so that would decide their future stability. And to also obtain the best possible high-resolution long-term climate records from the coastal ice rises. Because unlike many parts of the Antarctica, the coastal regions are not the best for ice core studies simply because you have very thin ice available and also the accumulation is so high. The only possibility to look at longer term records as well as which is probably not melting are the places where the ice rises are, because they're also elevated compared to the normal ice shelves. Therefore, they are better in terms of altitude. And we finally want to integrate the complement of interest. Like we are always, the NCOR is interested in ice core studies. We have developed some kind of experience, though I don't call it an expertise. And the Norwegian Polar Institute have an experience and expertise in the geophysical studies as well as the glaciological studies. So that's the premise we start. We started in 2016-17. We had the first major collaborative expedition all the way in Nibelsen ice shelf. Going away, starting from Maitri. In fact, they came from the Troll station and joined at Maitri together, worked together. We worked very well. And, then we had a convoy which is went beyond the limits of the typical what we used to do in the past with the Maitri. Went to two ice races, two ice cores, carried out plenty of DGPS measurements as well as ice radars. And And this, it would be extended this year. In fact, the team is, or the second team is already there. I could not join. So they are already drilling here at about 70 meters. They drilled again here because they want to have the deeper possible record there. And parallelly, another team is finding way to reach here. The team is already reached here, the Rekke team, because this is something beyond the boundaries of Maitri anytime. First time we have went all the way, there is a team which is already Indo-Norwegian team, the Rekke team, only doing reconnaissance, reaching this particular ice race. They have established a route, safe route. And let's see, even if you can't drill this year, if the time short, we are still able to have, we have made a route ready. And thereafter, they would be again moving here, reoccupying, because our understanding is not just to do one kind of measurement, also to understand the flow. So how much is flowing every year, because we already have made some measurements. Those stakes are already there. They are reoccupying this year. There are also some phase-sensitive radars and so on. I would say, give you another slide. In nutshell, what we did last year. We did a very long ice radars. There are two phase-sensitive radars. You can read here what I wrote. I don't know whether it's too readable. And then plenty of DGPS measurements, about nearly 2,000 of them. And there is, you can see the very high-resolution DGPS measurements to create a very high-quality digital elevation model. This ice core drilling here, this radar again here, again on this same ice rise, again another all sort of measurements. So it's quite a very field intensive, about nearly 40 to 45 days on the field, and the team worked very well. And as I said, actually we collected also the longest possible ice core last year, and we hope to again extend it this further this year. That's the always every year we want to improve it further and further. And the geophysical measurements, we had basically elevation measurements, they set up the stakes, ice thickness measurements, and glacial feature we wanted to understand using high resolution, high frequency radar, low frequency radar, and to understand the strain rates and basal melting, they established the phase sensitive radars, and also set up a weather station. In fact, the weather station is still safe, and they could pick it up this year. So that's some picture of what they have been doing using this kind of vehicles. Basically, the snow skidoos. They collected about nearly 1,900 line kilometers of DGPS surveys over two ice rays and the shelves. And the radar again from the history of Indian Antarctic Expedition. This was the longest radar surveys. Altogether, about nearly 700 kilometers long, more than 700 kilometers long, ground penetrating radar surveys using both low frequency as well as high frequency radar. And that's the how some results I would be just showing here just to give it a flavor rather. So, this is the digital elevation model they created based on the high resolution, high quality data obtained. And yeah, that's and also validated with the available satellite data. They also validated the available satellite data. That means a very robust data at the moment. And this is about the ice thickness data using the radar. You know, there's a lot of details to it. I would not go those details actually. Each of those, endurance features has the meaning and what is happening to the ice rise and how it's in the past it's been shifting. That's the rock as well as the ice boundary, and whether these are the features. And this again the another similar ice rise, wherein actually you can also see some of these very specialized glacial features. And again, it's on the ice shelf. And one thing which I want to just show here actually, it's also this a very interesting feature which we still find as an glacial feature within this ice rise. They've been shifting the midpoint, what we call it, the Raymond bump, which is the shifting through time, which is also an indication, possibly, because this needs to be a lot of study further, possibly indicating the ice rise has been retreating because of the ice shelf itself is slightly retreating. And we also tried to match it with an ice core record, because ice core record find a lot of this beautiful what you call melt layers, which are annual events which happens in the shelf region. So such kind of melt, the larger melt events could also be identified in this shift. That's something which we want to really further look into it. And I just want to stop here because also there are some results just coming up. So this is too early for us to make any interpretations, but we just want to stress here that the shallow ice core records are really making a lot of difference for the better understanding of the last 2000 years, because they provide the best high resolution records. And ice core, ice rakes is found to be one of the best possible areas to get such kind of shallow ice core cores. I think with that actually I just stop it because it's too tight for me to talk more details. Just want to thank the Ministry of Science as well as the Research Council Norway because it happened all because of that kind of support. And of course, we are very good, excellent team with the logistics supporting us. Thanks a lot. I hope I stood by the task.